In this video I show you an oil catch can in Mercedes diesel engine. So welcome on Ticking Watch, my name is Sebastian and this is what I bought a set from AliExpress and what we have inside. Some mounting plates, probably I will not use them. Here is the oil catch can itself. This is the can, seems to be pretty robust. It's actually designed for BMW and I tell you why I actually choose this one. I have here also four clamps for automotive and most important, actually also important, we have here two hoses, pretty robust silicone rubber hoses. The diameter here is pretty big and that's the reason why I choose this set. And this is the oil catch can and the most important thing why I choose this one. Let's unscrew the can and let's disassemble it a little bit how it is built. So we have here a o-ring, a gasket. The can itself isn't too big, capacity close to a glass, and we have here a baffle that is screw. This is the inlet here. And yeah, here's a place for screws. And the inlet diameter is about 18 millimeter. So it's pretty similar like the original hoses. So the original diameter. So I don't think this can will cause much flow resistance, or at least should be similar to the original hose, to the original system. Okay, let's remove now the baffle. We have here two screws. Let's remove them. It's quite easy. And the baffle, or let's say some kind of filter, is, yeah, it consists from two parts and we have here two screws. So we can also screw back this baffle to the other side and from the inlet we can make an outlet. It depends from the solution how we install the oil catch can inside the car, inside the engine. So it works, so it is built. I'm wondering, maybe I can screw it in a different way, maybe like that, but it shouldn't be like that. Okay. Probably effectiveness of this oil catch can isn't the biggest strength here, but on the other side we have low flow resistance and that's quite important for the engine and for its seals. Yeah, we could also screw it like this and change the inlet with the outlet, but I will leave it like I have it. Everything is aluminium. I'm installing here the oil catch can because I want to reduce the carbon build in the intake manifold and also in the burning chamber of the engine. Some particles here and there on the screw. Okay, so that's the implication installation. I have some pictures here. So it is built. This is a heater. And as you see, the hoses fits very good to the whole oil catch can. I install it in some kind of bracket, the screws on the top are different of course, but the same diameter. And yeah, well, so it looks like pretty convenient place and I also pay attention to that the length or the way from the oil separator to the outlet will be as less as possible, as short as possible actually. And I think I reached the goal here. Everything is clamped or secured with the clamps and there is also white tape. I put the white tape there because there's also a connector and it may chafe the hose. Here I can see I have to replace the gasket on the oil filler cap. And yeah, well, That's the installation.
Okay guys, let's check the oil catch can. I made about 1000 kilometers. And first thing that I noticed, it's pretty difficult to unscrew it with hands. Therefore, I will use this equipment to get some help. This is pretty easy. Okay. I made about 1000 kilometers from the last drying. And let's see what we have now. There were wet days, there were cold evenings. So give me a few seconds. Mostly there was water inside, absolutely no oil. But let's see, as you see, it's easy to get to this oil catch can. And what I have here is, well, actually, let's put some light. Actually, nothing inside, yeah? Little bit water, slightly some oil, not too much. Yeah, so what can I say? The oil separator here works pretty perfect. So this is it. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Take care. And I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye bye.